أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لتراب مقدمه الفداء شيعتنا يفرحون لفرحنا ويحزنون لحزننا Our followers are happy in our happiness and sad and grieved in our sadness. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Congratulations on the auspicious occasion of the birth anniversary of Sayyidatun Nisa al-Alameen, the best and the most virtuous lady of the world, of the worlds, both in this world and the hereafter, Sayyidatun Nisa al-Jannah, the most virtuous lady of paradise, Fatima az-Zahra, Bada'atu Rasulullah, part of the Holy Prophet of Islam, Ummul A'imma, the mother of all the Imams and the mother and the source of all the virtues. On this auspicious occasion, allow me to convey our congratulations, sincere congratulations on behalf of all of us to our present Imam, Imam Al-Hujja Ajjalallahu Ta'ala Farajahu Sharif. Usually because gatherings as such that we are celebrating the birth of especially the Holy Fatima az-Zahra, peace be upon her, that is marked normally as the Women's Day, Mother's Day. It's a family gathering, brothers, sisters, family, they come together. The topic that I have chosen, inshallah, to share with you quite briefly, inshallah, tonight, is about the skill of positive thinking. Inshallah, throughout my speech, you'll find out that we can really relate it to our day-to-day life a lot. In order for you to know what I'm talking about and how this topic is related to our life, let me give you some example of it. Whether you have been involved in this situation or you've heard about it, as a family counselor, fortunately or unfortunately, I've come across a lot of such examples. Brothers or sisters, very often it happens to the sisters and even brothers as well, that once they are in a turmoil of life, once they are, as we say, the ship of our life is not sailing along with the wind, once we have a problem in our business, in our education, in our family life, and things are not going so well in our family situation, we start complaining, or God forbid if there is an illness, terminating illness in us, in one of our dear members of the family members. We start complaining to God. God, come on, what's going on? Why only me? What have I done to deserve this, really? I don't know why out of everybody God has to test me alone. A few weeks ago, a lady, she was confiding with me and telling me about her situation. And she said that for over 10 years, I've been serving in the Husayniyyah, in the house of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And now look at me now, been diagnosed with a cancer, bedridden in the hospital, and my husband also has divorced me. What else could happen to me? Why God is doing this to me? For God's sake, so why? Why only me then? See, very often if we come across, I come across situations like this, that people, they start complaining to God about the situation that they are in. Every day we face events in our life. What I'm trying to say that whether these events are negative or positive, it really is here. It depends on our interpretations of it. The actual events, sort of, they are neutral, and that's why various people, they react to it differently. I'll give you an example. If somebody asks you and I that, in your opinion, what do you think for an adolescent, for a teenage boy or girl to die? Is it something good or evil? death for a teenager, is it good or evil? Immediately you say that it's evil. And what do you think that if all of a sudden a lady loses all her children, a lady loses all her brothers, all her family members, in front of her eyes they are slain and killed, is it something good and evil? You say, wow, that's horrible. Now, I tell you that the same has happened to Qasim al-Hasan, one of the young soldiers of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. We all know this story, that the night before, when Imam Hussein alayhi salam is asking him that, how is death to you? And he says, ahla min al-asal, sweeter than honey. Sweeter than honey. Never say that it's terrible, it's horrible. No, I don't want it. Why me? Sayyida Zainab, in front of her eyes, she lost her sons, her brothers, all her dears, all members of her family. Yet she says, "Ma ra'aytu illa jamila." I saw but beauty. Allahu Akbar. I saw but beauty, despite all what she had gone through. So what I'm trying to say is that things happen in our lives, but it depends on how you and I interpret it, whether we think positive or negative. Then it becomes evil or good, based on our interpretation. Our Islam, the teachings of Islam, always is trying to tell us and to teach us to think positive, to have a very positive view to the world and the events in the world, and nothing evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran is telling us that whatever that appears to you to be evil, باطنه فيه الرحمة وظاهره من قبله العذاب. Deep inside it is blessing, is rahmah. But apparently it seems to be torment, punishment, evil, tough, that you don't like it. But deep inside it, there is definitely a mercy, nothing other than mercy. That's why again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to the issue of a divorce, huh? To us, nobody likes it. Nobody gets married to be divorced. But if so happened that there was compelling reasons that these two, husband and wife, they could not really live together peacefully, and they had, their marriage had to end in divorce. Quran says, عَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُوا. Subhanallah, reflect on this ayah. How often things that you don't like them, but it's good for you. How often things that you like them, but it's evil for you, it's not good for you. God knows and you don't know. That shows that the way that we interpret events is not necessarily according to the truth, to the reality as they are. How often we have this ayah repeated in the Quran, وَمَا ظَلَمَهُمُ اللَّهُ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. Rest assured that God is never and will never is unfair to anyone and oppresses anyone. God is absolutely just and will never treat us unjustly. So if I am in a terrible situation, so-called terrible situation, it's just because I cannot see the senses in it. I cannot make some senses out of it. Otherwise, definitely rest assured that إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِعِبَادِهِ لَخَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ. Please repeat after me again this ayah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِعِبَادِهِ لَخَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ. Verily, surely, lo, behold, that Allah, the Almighty God, surely, definitely, when it comes to His creation, to His slaves, and we are all the slaves of God, He is all aware and all seer. So, when you are in a situation, when I'm bedridden in bed, when I'm in fever, when I'm losing a job, when I'm in the middle of a very tense family situation that is really getting to the crunch, that I'm screaming, that I cannot take it anymore, say, God, I cannot hack it anymore, please. Rest sure God is watching you. God is fully seer, fully knower. He knows what's happening. There's a wisdom in that. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Don't ever think that God is taking a nap or he's asleep and therefore he's oblivious of what's going on. Absolutely not. پیر ما گفت خطا بر قلم سون نرفت آفرین بر نظر لطف خطا پوشش باد صلو علی محمد و آل محمد اللهم صل علی محمد و آل محمد Now, the question is this How are we supposed to deal with the hardship and difficulties of our life? There are two different approaches. The approach of a pessimistic person, the approach, and the second is the approach of a optimistic person. The one who thinks positive, the one who thinks negative. I give an example. Instead of in such situation that I mentioned, when it comes to the hardship of our life, instead of sitting and nagging and complaining to God, and putting all the blames on others, starting with God, which is a very, very dhannal jahili, as Quran says. That's having an ignorant thought of God. Instead of doing so, we have to read between the lines. We have to benefit from it. I have to really reflect and think that, hey, this sickness of mine, this family issue that happened in my life, and examples varies from person to person. I'm afraid somehow, sometimes in our lives, we all have experienced it. What has happened to me now that I don't like it? It's happening for a reason. I better benefit. It's a test from God. Deal with it as the prophet, such as Prophet Dawood, ala nabiyyina wa alihi wa alayhi salam, dealt with it. How? Long story short, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Sa'd has mentioned this story that whether in reality or in his dream to test him, a man comes to Prophet Dawood and he says that, look, Ya Rasulallah, I've got only one ewe, female sheep, liya na'jatun wahida, and my brother has got 99 ewes. And yet he wants to take the only one that I've got for him. Immediately Dawood says that, qad zalamak. He's been unfair to you. He was not supposed to do this. Although his judgment was right, but because he did not listen to the other side before he gives his verdict, the Almighty God blamed him for that. Prophet Dawood, who found that he slipped and he did make a mistake that he was not supposed to have done that, Quran says, but he benefited from that. He learned from his mistakes. He realized that that was a test. He used that opportunity to elevate himself, not to jump down. See, there's a platform. Some they ascend, some they go down to it. So hardships in our lives, brothers and sisters, are like platform where it's up to you want to jump down and go under the train or you want to take off. وَظَنَّ دَاوُودُ أَنَّمَا فَتَنَّاهُ فَاسْتَغْفَرَ رَبَّهُ فَخَرَّ رَاكِعًا وَأَنَاب Quran says that Prophet Dawood realized that this is a test from God. What's happening to him is a test from God. And therefore what he said he did, immediately he flipped it around, he sought Allah's forgiveness, bowed before him, and he returned to God. He took advantage of that opportunity to return to God. The pessimistic example also is mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with regards to the chief of all the pessimistic people, i.e. Shaitan, says that Shaitan, when he slipped and refused to prostrate before Adam, and as a result of that he was expelled, instead of repenting, instead of learning from that, instead of considering that as like a wake-up call to him, he turns around and says that فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صَرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ You deceived me, God. You, it was your fault. Just because you deceived me, now I'm gonna take revenge and sit on the path, the right path, to make sure that this man Adam and his offspring, they cannot make it to paradise. See? So we have a pessimistic approach and optimistic approach. A sister, the one that I mentioned to you that some weeks ago, she was confiding about some of the issues that she had, a very serious family problem. We are having although a happy occasion, but unfortunately that's something that it's quite epidemic and common these days. She was telling me that, look, Sheikh, what's happening to me? How my husband is ill-treating me? And I turned around and said to her that, sister, Can I be honest with you? I'm not condoning what he's doing. Yes, he's ill-treating you, but can you tell me that, are you ill-treating God or not? How is your relation with God? Frankly speaking, when was the last time that you offered your morning prayer? And she really went thinking. And she confessed, she said, you're right. It's been a while, actually, that I'm slacking out in my relation with God. See, get the checklist. We all know basics of Islam. Go through the checklist of your obligations, whether I'm slacking out to in any of them or not. Things happen for a reason. The hardship of our lives, as Quran said about Prophet Dawood, fatannahu, this is a test, it's a wake-up call. Take it as a wake-up call so that it helps us to wake up, to make a U-turn. I said to her that, sister, because God has extra care, He loves you. And you've been going astray. The way that you are going is the wrong way. Go back. Because we don't wake up sometimes, God has to put us through some hardship to plead to God, to anab, to return to God. And Sayyidah Fatima az-Zahra, salamullah alayha, she has a brilliant hadith to tell us what is the solution, how we can really get out of that situation in such a successful way. If you help me, salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, I'll share it with you, inshallah. Sallu ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. عن سيدة النساء صلوات الله عليها قالت من أسعد إلى الله خالص عبادته أهبط الله عز وجل إليه أفضل مصلحته صدقت ولية الله فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها according to this hadith, brilliant heavenly hadith, she says that whoever sends up to Allah sincere devotion, or her sincere devotion, male or female is the same. Then as a result of that, what goes around comes around. As a result of your sincere devotion to God, the Almighty Allah will send down to you, He send down to Him His best interest, meaning that whatever that will be for His best interest. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting with his companions, and all of a sudden they saw that the Prophet laughed, smiled very, and in fact, sort of laughing. They were surprised. Ya Rasulallah, you never laugh. What happened? The Messenger of God, he said that just because the Jibreel came down to me now, brought a message from the Almighty God saying that, inform the believers that whatever happens to them, at the end of the day, it is going to be for their maslaha. It's going to be a benefit for them. If you are only conscious of that, if you can get the benefit, the wisdom out of that, and take advantage of it. Now, the ruling that we have in Islam, when it comes to whether I'm expected to think positive or negative with regards to situations between me and God and relations with my fellow humans, is an ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, chapter 49, that inshallah I read the part that is related to our topic, and I will request if you can please bless your mouth and repeat it with me under breath, so that inshallah we can benefit from the spirituality of the ayah. Surah Al-Hujurat, ayah number 12. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم صلى الله عليه وسلم. That part that we needed to know for now. O you who believe, avoid much assumption. Indeed, some assumptions are sins. This is a general rule that we have. This is a principle. This is the doctrine of Islam when it comes to whether I'm expected to think positive in relation between me and God, and as well as in relation with me and my fellow humans around me. Quran says, if you are a believer, اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. This اجتنبوا is an expression that Quran is using for horrible sins, such as worshipping idols, idolatry, such as drinking alcohol and intoxicants. And likewise, he's using it here for suspicions. uses four assumptions, meaning the wrong assumptions. اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. Why Quran says most of your suspicions you have to avoid it? Because the problem is that most of the time, unfortunately, we think negative. We see a guy and a girl talking to each other. Immediately, the first crosses our mind is that, what's going on? What sort of illegal relation do they have with one another? Come on, take it easy. Maybe they're brother and sister. Maybe they're mahram to each other. You don't know. Relax. But first that comes to our mind, many of us unfortunately, is negative assumption. And that's why Quran says, كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ. Then Quran says, إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمِ. Not all your assumptions are sinful and sins, but some of them. Now to take precaution, to make sure that this assumption that I have about someone, about my wife, about my husband, about my brother, about my sister, about my friend, about my colleague, about my teacher, about this sheikh, about someone else, these assumptions is not a sinful assumption, avoid it, repel it, think positive. This is in general. Also, you can apply it in relation between me and God. The ayah does not limit it to any particular situation. So the ruling is very general. So in relation with our social life, especially, I want to relate it more as a family gathering, inshallah, to benefit. That's a gift in such a holy and blessed night I want to share with you so that all of us, inshallah, we take it home. That's the best gift that we can give to our spouse tonight, to think positive about each other. Imagine. Usually, and I'm not trying to create any problem, it's a Mother's Day, it's a Woman's Day. Some men, they buy a bunch of flour for their wives, for example, or their mothers as a gift. Some, they don't. Now, let's have a pessimistic approach and optimistic approach about it. A pessimistic lady, if her husband buys her a bunch of flour, she says, come on, I know, he's just trying to fool me. God knows what is in his mind, what is want to do. A positive thinking lady, she admires that. And she says, oh, my husband really loves me. She knows I love flowers, and look, he's buying me. He knows I love flowers, and he's buying it for me. And if he doesn't, if he's just oblivious and he doesn't. A pessimistic lady, she turns and says that, look, he doesn't care about me. My husband never cares about me. The one who thinks positive, she says that, no, my husband is too busy. Really. He's expressing his love in a different way. Different people, they express their love differently. Not that because he doesn't buy me flower means that he doesn't love me. See, what I'm trying to say that is that there is one event out there with two different approaches, positive or negative. Which one am I supposed to take? Quran says, Riwayat says, inshallah, I will back it up with some more Riwayat, have to be positive, think positive, try to interpret what others have done or are doing as positive as you can. A man who unfortunately is a sinful person, has always lustful look and has evil intention and action towards others, women, he is also very suspicious of his wife and other men. Because of his own attitude, he thinks that everyone is like this. It has made him a pessimistic person. We have all experienced that. Whereas those who are innocent and really have that innocent look and their heart, as Quran says, فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٍ, they don't have that sickness in their heart. They always give the benefit of the heart, benefit of the doubt to others as well, and they are not suspecting or they are not accusing others. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters, one confession here, if I may make, for us to learn from. If somebody tells me, Sheikh Mansour, what was the biggest and the most repeated mistakes that you have made in your life? You know what I say? In all honesty? Being judgmental. I repeat, being judgmental. Huh? That means I'm telling you that the one that I'm more conscious about it, at least, and I found out later on, and I felt so bad about it later on, was about being judgmental, judging on others, jumping to a conclusion that later on I regretted it. In order for us to avoid that regretful situation, Quran, Riwayat, they say that think positive. Think positive. Here is the hadith from Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi afdalu salawati wa tahiyyat, that the Imam says this is a rule, it's a command. Wa' amra akhik ala ahsanih, hatta ya'tiyaka minhuma yaghlibuk. وَلَا تَظُنَّنَّ بِكَلِمَةٍ خَرَجَتْ مِنْ أَخِيكَ سُوءًا وَأَنْتَ تَجِدُ لَهَا فِي الْخَيْرِ مَحْمِلًا. Imam Ali alayhi salam says that place the action of your brother, your sister, your partner, your spouse, your colleague, a believer, place it in the best possible way, meaning interpret it in the best positive way that you can. Endeavor to find a positive interpretation for it as much as possible. Other riwayat says that even if you have to search, use your intelligence, try to endeavor, like someone that you love, that how, when it comes to your sister, to your brother, how unconsciously you really justify it, likewise expand it to others. This good attitude that you have when it comes to your near of kin, expand it to others as well. Believe me, you will be in peace of mind first and foremost yourself, and you won't regret things later on. And the Imam says that, and don't ever, when he says something, don't ever misinterpret it. It's about interpretation. Don't ever misinterpret it. So much as you can find a positive interpretation for it, don't ever give it any negative interpretation. And at the end of the day, if you could not, go and find out. Gently, amicably, friendly, ask him or ask her that, I'm sorry, could you please tell me what did you mean when you said that? Most of the time we should not go and ask people for it. I should interpret it positively. But if I failed and I couldn't, just ask them gently, could you please explain, because I'm not sure if I got you correctly, rather than just jumping into a conclusion, judging and regretting it later on. I will sum it up with some benefits of positive thinking, inshallah, as I'm not supposed to take much of your time. You've got other items, the agenda tonight. Positive thinking has some benefits. All of them come back to us and to our family members, to our society. First and foremost is that you will be less regretful, as I told you, and less embarrassed. Who wants to be embarrassed? Who wants to regret things? Therefore, let us practice to speak less about others, negatively especially. Think positive when it comes to others. Second, it keeps you healthier. Healthy body, healthy mind, and vice versa. What I'm trying to say is that the studies show today that those who think positive and are optimistic people, they are less stressed. And we all know what stresses do to our body. Huh? It reduces our defense mechanism, immune system. So if you don't want to suffer physically, think positive. It starts from here. Before I hurt anyone, I have to hurt myself if I want to think negative and evil about others. I have to create an evil within myself, then if I can expand it to others. So why? For what reason? Think positive. Imam Ali alayhi salam says in Nahjul Balagha that if you can be the most forbearing person, Halim, be so. If not, pretend that you are, excuse the expression, you are a donkey, that you don't understand. It makes you healthier, believe me, easier. Rather than you think that, turn and say, I'm not a stupid. I know what you mean. How do you know? Even, you can read people's mind. Honestly, how often have we been proven wrong? And she innocently turns and says, Wallah, I never meant it. I swear to God, that was never in my mind. And I jumped to a conclusion and I regretted it, what do you call it later on. The third benefit is that isolates a problem. If I think positive, it isolates the problem. There's a problem in my business, for example. There's a problem with my wife. There's a problem in something else. Doesn't mean that I expand it to every aspect of my life. And I become like encompassed in evils around me. Quran mentions this with when it comes to hypocrite men and women and disbelieving men and women. In Surah Al-Fath, read it later on, that Quran says that وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ الظَّانِّينَ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّ السَّوْءِ عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ السَّوْءِ. Those who have evil thoughts about God, that are only hypocrites, male or females, disbelievers, males or females. Quran says, you know what happens? The evil thought that they had, the pessimism that they had towards God, it encompasses evil and puts them into a hellfire in this dunya. Why do you need to do that? So if I think positive, at least I can isolate that problem and I can treat it and I can get rid of it easier from my system, rather than expand it to every aspect of my life. Rather than just because I've got an issue at work, my family members have to suffer, my wife has to suffer, my children have to suffer, everyone else has to suffer. No, my friend. Isolate it and then it's easier to get rid of it. And finally, does not put you down. As I said, if we don't think positive, if we think negative, and as Quran says very often, you will be proven wrong. Then what happens is that Quran, as Quran says in Surah Fussilat, ardaakum. Ardaakum, it means that your evil thought will cause you to be destroyed, will cause you to be down. Who wants to put himself or herself down? If you don't want others to put you down, don't put yourself down by thinking negative, by being pessimistic. You will suffer, and very often you will be proven wrong, and we suffer, and we make others around us suffer as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to think positive. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His blessing upon us, so that inshallah we can also teach our children from the very young age how they should think positive and how they are expected to be optimistic people. Wa kullu amin wa antum bi alfi khair. Sallu ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammadin bi a'la aswatikum.